first interview. He started all the way back in 2004 with the group Wazanasi KS. Welcome to the East Circuit.
Shukran sana, Mika.
Asante sana. Ulikuwa unafaa kukuja na rafiki yetu bana. Kid is the jembe. You have a new song with him. What happened? Where is he?
I may send his apologies.
Yeah.
Hajatoka kukamu leo. But he'll come next time.
Hakuna shida. Actually, I like that you came because, you know, the conversation will still be the same. You know, the thing is, you and Kiddis, mlianza way back when, you know, when Kapuka bado ilikuwa inaanza, inashika vizuri. And I say, umeona the evolution of music in Kenya. Okay, angalia, then and now, the conversations play KE and all that. Do you feel like now people are starting to appreciate Kenyan music again?
Actually, guys are appreciating more Kenyan music now more than ever.
Yeah.
Because avenues za kuleta muziki zime expand. You know, with the internet and all that, inapatia more space for everyone. Yeah, that's why you're seeing all these guys, all these new artists coming. So it's a good opportunity.
I'll no longer talk about Gengeton and, you know, SG, whether there's content or not. Mm-hmm. It clearly has content because it has a fan base, yeah? Our VP guys, you know?
Quelly.
It's a fan base.
Yeah, it's gonna,
So it's no longer about content. It's about appreciation and all those things in between so that our artists start to make money. Kumekona, the stories, as Jay Isha, Zuko, the same about promoters. Yeah, in the morning, we were also talking about, you know, Wendy Waini na vile. A promoter, Aki Alimfanya, she's still living the same situation. In the entertainment industry, kumekuwa na hizo story mingi.
Mingi sana.
Kumekuwa, is it becoming any better for artists to protect themselves against such things?
All right, our industry is still very young.
Yeah.
Although it has come a long way. So excuse me, at least kuna bodies ambazo neza register nazo. You see there's MCSK, there's Prisk, there's Camp. And you can sell your music on other platforms like Songa, you see, Boomplay. So ni msanii ajue where to go. Ukiingia na muziki wako fast, you should not just release it bila kuregister na watu. Yeah, so you stay protected.
And a copyright inafanya kazi vile inafaa, because I remember hata there was a time walikatazwa kwanza for a minute
for like
from collecting,
like, sasa, you know, it goes deep down. Shida ya muziki, si ya muziki pekee, just the way you said about the sports industry. Guys are too corrupt. Unaona? So unapata, yes, there's these bodies, but saa zingine hazikuwa effective. Mpaka zinasimamishwa kazi. You get? That's why you see, like, you have, kuna msanii ako na manager, lakini manager anaangalia tu ile hela ya msanii.
Anaona ni nini anazachukua kwako, anataka kukujenga.
Aoni vile mnaweza jengana, and you'll go even further together.
Ubinafsi mingi iko kwa industry.
Ubinafsi iko kwa industry. And not only music. Unajua tukipiga kelele tunaambia wasanii mnapiga kelele sana.
Na bado pia kwa sports tunaona kile kimefanyika.
Yeah. Kenyans are too greedy, but I think it's all about the leaders we elect. It's all about leadership. Sababu wao ndio wanatupatia mwelekeo na mfano. You know, so if I look up to the people I look up to, wako na fishy ideas and they get away with it. Hata huku chini tutafanya hivyo. It goes deep.
Kwa sababu utafanya vile unaonyeshwa
yani. Hey, unaona yule jamaa aliba milioni ngapi? And he's still walking around and flossing. Iko sawa.
Na mimi yangu acha pia mimi nichukue.
Acha hata mimi nichukue, life is short. YOLO.
YOLO.
Yeah.
Kali.
Yeah,
so but I believe it will get better eventually because people like you, you know, are you staying firm with the industry now? Bado mnaendelea kutuletea hits after hits.
Yeah.
Let's go back to Wazanasi, the group. Mlikuwa mnafanya Afropop, Kapuka?
What do I call
it? Hip-hop.
It was a combination of Kapuka, hip-hop, because tulikuwa wanne. And everyone had their own taste.
Ni nini ilikuwa imewa bring together before we talk about what split you apart?
Tuko tumeletwa pamoja, unajua vijana wa mtaani, when you finish high school, that period before you join college, huwa mna mabest, mna hang out, your neighbors. So we were like, there were three of them. And tukapata na time flani, we were playing football. So in the middle of that game, we started doing freestyles. And there's one of us who had a friend in the suburbs there, Walpana Studio. So akasema, hey, you guys, we should go do a song. So me nika wa company, I was not actually going to rap
with them. Oh, you're going to hang out.
And I'm going to hang out too now. So when I dropped my lines, waka like, and we did a song. Salam Aleikum. It's way back. Lafu, they liked the song and we formed a group from there.
Now, from 2004, when did you guys split?
I think around 2009.
2009?
2009 to 2010, because that's when I did my first single.
So that's around the 5-6 years hapo, mmekuwa pamoja, releasing hits. Ni nini ulipata from that experience within the group, so that you know, ni nini inakusaidia as a solo artist now?
Well, brand ni muhimu sana.
Brand?
Yeah, brand, because even after I split, I called myself SK at first. But now I'm KS, it's still the same thing. But nilijua, growing a brand ni kazi, si kazi rahisi. So at least with my experience in the group, as a solo artist now it's much easier because I know what I'm not supposed to do and what
I'm supposed to
do.
And you can make the decisions much faster because you're
exactly, exactly. Alafu najua mko kwa group, everyone akona style yake, mtu anasema, I feel this song more, you know.
Different
but
opinions.
But for me, different opinions. But right now it's just me and the producer.
In terms of brand, yeah?
Yeah.
Kuna social media. Unaonekana imetusaidia ama sasa inafanya artists wanaanza ku go nuts because people are doing crazy things to remain relevant. You know
exactly,
what I mean, yeah?
Exactly, yeah.
Unaona gospel artists wanaanza kutoa sijui anataka kulamba sukari gani. Unajua? So unaeleweki.
Yeah, tunaweza sema actually nimeka na two things za kusema. The first one, wa Kenya tunapenda shortcuts. Ukiangalia wasanii wengi wenye wame blow big, people know them by one song, but they don't know the behind the scenes that you wamefanya for years before atoke. You can look at Kidis mwenyewe, you know, Naiboy. Before they came on the scene, walikuwa wamefanya ngoma nyingi sana, wengine albums, but they were never known. So, kupenda shortcut ni mbaya sana. Because hata mimi nikitaka shortcut leo, I just strip ni simame hapa nje.
Kupiga picha weke social.
Ndiyo hiyo sasa na nchat trend.
Ume blow up hapa, pants,
exactly.
Whatever.
Exactly, in just a week's time.
Any crazy. Waache shortcuts, yeah.
Waache shortcuts.
Wafanye bidii, wafanye kazi.
Exactly. And second thing ni, kuna mtu aliniambia, every sown seed never goes to waste. So, ile little effort unafanya, hata kama haijabear fruit, haijaenda waste. Because there's
someone watching. Eventually, utaona matokeo baadaye.
Exactly.
Na kuna this new song nataka tuongelee, umetoka kufanya na Kibis, The Jembe. Kidis, I know you're watching. Malo umejificha saizi, najua likuwa mko likata kuamka. Akwanza kwa wapi umzama?
Jama labda akini WhatsApp nakwambia labda amelala mahali hauwezi jua.
Ngoma ni kali inaitwa Ongeza Nusu.
Yeah.
I want to ask what's the inspiration to the song because you know Ongeza Nusu imekuwa tamu au vipi? Lakini ni nini ile bring together when a Kidis?
Okay, actually Kidis song yake ya kwanza yenye ilikuwa commercial alikuwa ameifanyia video na studio mali tuko Spikes Music. Yeah, he used to do hip hop then. Apple Spikes. So eventually when you tulifanya video, the song was good. Na kablow up from there. So that's when we knew each other. Alafu najua wasanii tunajiona see what it's just a small circle.
It's a small circle.
Hata kama tujai meet tunaona kazi za mwenzetu.
Lakini hata kama umenyamaza umekanya
exactly. Wengine tunawa inbox au tu blue tick ni sawa tu.
Wanajulikana.
Tutapatana tu huko mbele baadaye. Yeah, so that's how we met. So from the same studio. But working together imeanza last year. Yeah. And kuna more music coming.
Kuna more collaborations and you umewakia kama KS. What should we anticipate from you now? Because unajua you've learned all these tricks umeona the ins and outs of the entertainment industry ever since 2004 kutoka ukwe kwa group. Now you're a solo artist.
Yeah.
So what should we expect from you?
Okay, actually KS is also a producer. I've done production of most of my work. Hata hiyo Ongeza Nusu, it's my production. So, what you can expect is good music from KS. Kuna mziki nimefanya pia Kidis, anafanya videos very soon. Yeah. The party won't stop.
Party won't stop.
Yeah.
Safi kabisa. Asante sana, shukran kwa kukuja. Kutuangelesha about the industry, I hope. Next time, unaweza kama na mjamaa. Kidis.
Lazima ndamuamusha.
Umrute kwa hiyo jule. Atuzi tuongee na yeye tafadhali. Because Kidis always has, you know, just like you.
Yeah.
It's very insightful with this industry. Na vile imekuwa ikigrow, ikichange.
Yeah, upon experience.
And we need such big brothers like you to, nadzwe, this is an edutainment show.
Yeah.
Kuelimisha our young artists who wanna come. So watu wanaweza kupata wapi on social media?
Social media, Twitter, at the only KS, K ni K-A-Y-S, Instagram at the only KS, Facebook at the only KS.
Safi kabisa.
Mtaani pia the only chaos.
Remember, the question of the day is, should we ban sports gambling in Kenya? Let us know on Y254 channel and the East Circuit. Until then, this is KIDIS KS. Ongeza nusu.